वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स ऑन टूडेज लेक्चर ऑन डिज़ाइन ऑफ टेंशन मेम्बर्स। सो एज डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव सॉल्व न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑफ एनालिसिस फॉर द डिज़ाइन ऑफ टेंशन मेम्बर्स एज वेल एज डिज़ाइनिंग अ टेंशन मेम्बर यूजिंग अ सिंगल एंगल एंड डबल एंगल सेक्शंस। सो टूडे वी शाल डिस्कस अ फ्यू इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट, अ पार्ट विच इज़ कॉल्ड एज अ लग एंगल, which is called as a lug angle. Now first let us discuss what is this lug angle. Lug angle is nothing but an angle section only, but when a connection is made, normal connection, say for example if a gusset plate is connected with a single angle section or a double angle section, and if we get the length of the member as too large in length, so obviously what will happen, the connection will increase, either the length of the weld will increase or the number of bolt system will increase. If the number of bolts, if we get more, so what will happen, the length of the member will increase, and also after providing the more number of bolts in an angle section with a gusset plate, what will happen is as the number of bolts are more, the number of bolt holes to be drilled are more. So it reduces the efficiency as well as the effective area for the angle section to provide the full strength. So what we do is we provide one extra angle. That extra angle is called as a lug angle. I will just explain you in the diagram. Say for example, this is a normal connection, that is a gusset plate with the angle. Now what we do is, this is the gusset plate and this is the main angle. So to reduce the number of bolting system and to reduce the length of the main angle, so what we do is we provide a extra angle, we call that angle as a lug angle. So that is, that angle is provided below the main angle. You can see this is the cross section and this is how the elevation goes, that is the top view. You can see here the main angle, the length is more, it is more greater. So what we do to reduce it, we provide a lug angle just below it, just to support the main angle. So this is the main purpose of the lug angle. So let us see how are the definitions and what are the advantages and disadvantages of the lug angle. So I have already explained you, the lug angle is nothing but the extra angle provided so as to reduce the length of the member as well as to reduce the bolted connections or number of bolts in the section. So let us see, if the length of the connection is more, it can be reduced by using a lug angle. So it is very simple. So as I have already discussed, now advantages, what are the advantages of the lug angle? Angle of the connection is reduced, sorry, the length of the connection is reduced. So you can see the length of the connection gets reduced as we are providing a supporting angle below, that is a lug angle. Disadvantages, the connection requires additional piece of an angle section. As you can see here, this is a lug angle. So what will happen here? We have to provide one more angle here. So that is the meaning of that part. Then the second, the overall number of bolt is more than the without the lug angle connection. So what will happen, even when we provide the lug angle here, so even we have to connect this lug angle to the gusset plate as well as the main angle. So even the bolt number of bolts may increase in some cases. Then the lug angle connection is slightly eccentric. So obviously it depends on the whether we are providing angle to be an equal angle or unequal angle, depending upon that the connection is given. So what is happening, the CG of the bolting system gets shifted, so that is called as a lug angle is slightly eccentric. Now as per IS 800 2007, we have a provision given for providing the lug angles. Let us see. So it is given on page number 83, clause number 10.12.2. So let us discuss. So this is a part. So lug angles connecting outstanding leg of a channel shaped member shall as far as possible be disposed symmetrically with respect to the section of the member. And this data, that is this clause 10.12.2, gives how to design a lug angle with in terms of percentages. I will just read it out. In case of an angle member, the leg angles and their connections to the gusset or other supporting members shall be capable of developing strength not less than 20% in excess of the force in the outstanding leg of the member. Now, what excess of the force? The force will be given for the designing, that is the force taken by the main angle. That has to be divided into two halves, that is out for force for the outstanding leg and force for the connected leg. So, what they say is it should be not be less than 20% of excess of the force in the outstanding member. And the attachment of lug angle to the main angle shall be capable of developing a strength not less than 40% in excess of the force in the outstanding leg of an angle. Now, this is they have given with respect to angle section. 10.12.3 gives with respect to the channel section. Same, you can see here. The lug angle and their connection to the gusset or other supporting members shall be capable of developing a strength not less than 10% in excess of the force. Similarly, with the angle, the attachment of the lug angles to the main member will be capable of developing 20% of the excess of the force. And the bolted connection and the welded connection, the strength of the weld and the bolt value calculation remains the same. Now, I have written it in a very short. So, these are the design steps which I have made. So, what is the first step? As per 10.12.2, the design of lug angle increase the force in the outstanding leg by 20% for the angles and for the channels by 10%. Next, when that is the lug angle increase, that is the force in the lug angle in the outstanding leg. Connection between lug angle and the gusset plate. Let us show you connection between the lug angle. This is the lug angle and the gusset plate. That is this connection they are talking about. So this connection, the force in the outstanding leg is increased by 20% for the angles and 10% for the channels. Now, connection between the lug angle and the main angle. Let us show you. Connection between the lug angle and the main angle. That is this connection. So, this connection, the connection between lug angle and main angle, the force in the outstanding leg is increased by 40% for the angles and for channel section 20%. So, this is how the design is to be done for the lug angle section for reducing the length of the connection. So much for the IS code provisions for the lug angle. So, dear students, be safe, stay home. Thank you.